Hi there. Today we're going to be making the Octa-Harp. It's one of my twin diatonic series. Two diatonic harmonicas behind a master mouthpiece. In this case, they're an octave apart, and you get this lovely, big, rich octave sound. Okay, I'll show you how easy it is to make one of these for yourself. Okay, you get a little bag of parts, all the bits you need to make your own Octa-Harp. And this is what's in the bag. So here you can see the main upper unit. That's 3D printed. This is a soft neoprene gasket, which is going to go on the back of there. And here are a couple of retaining screws and the retaining discs and some spacer kind of washers. So we're going to put them all together. So the first thing to start with is the main upper unit. Just on a piece of sandpaper or whatever, or using a file, just soften the outer edges of the plastic part. I'll just do it on the sandpaper here, just with a rolling motion. And you can see the edges are softened a bit. Okay, one more thing you could do on a piece of sandpaper if you want to is just to soften these sharp edges there. And I'm just going to hold the part on a piece of on my sandpaper. It'll be in between, sort of 45 degrees. I'll just give it a few strokes, and then on the same thing on the other side. And it just sort of softens that edge there a bit. Do it on a sort of a diagonal, that's the best thing. So the edge is a little bit softened, but all the main work is going to come with our little sanding block. Okay, so here's the sanding block. This is just a sponge sanding block. You can buy them for very, very little money on eBay, Amazon, whatever. It's got a rough surface and a slightly less rough surface. Start with the rough one. Just hold the part and just vigorously sort of rub everywhere. Start on the sides maybe. Turn it over. Just make sure you rub every part, the ends as well as the middle. It's really up to you how much sanding you want to do at this point. I don't do a huge amount because we're going to be putting some slicking solution on the part at the end, and that's going to soften and smooth all the parts, but it's really up to you. You can go for 10 minutes on this if you want to. I think that's overkill, but it's really your choice. For me, that's fine. I've done enough sanding now to soften the edges of these top mouth holes. So now just get a vacuum cleaner. Okay. So I'm using this plastic weld. It's very widely available. It's very thin solution, and it essentially melts the plastic. It's intended for model aircraft, putting them together. Just use a sort of whitish brush. It could be that or that, whatever. And don't put on too much of this stuff. Just rub the brush and slow down when you get to the end. If you don't do that, you kind of get an extra dollop of solution on the end where the brush bristles flick over. Dries very, very quickly, so within a few seconds you can turn it over. See, I'm just getting rid of the excess on the rim of the bottle there. Slowing down at the end here. Have the brush on a sort of a gentle angle, I don't know, 30 degrees or whatever it is. And I'll just give that a little bit of time to dry and then start over and just give it one more coat. You can give it as many coats as you like. The more coats you give it, the smoother the outer surface will be. But to be honest, I don't think it needs more than a couple of coats. Second or two before you touch it. And finally, one more along the top. Okay, that's all you need to do, and you've now got a very, very smooth, slicked plastic part that'll feel great in your mouth. Okay, the next thing to do is just to insert the neoprene gasket. First thing you need to do is just remove the protective backing from the adhesive bit. There we go. So when you're putting this on, just make sure it's centered this way as well as that way. Just do it by eye. Lay it down very gently so the middle partitions line up with the bit in the comb. Don't stick it down all the way. Just give it a quick look. Now, one way to make sure it goes in nicely is just use your fingernail and actually drag it along the side here, and that'll drag the neoprene nicely into the recession there. And then once you're happy it's all pretty much in place, just press it down a little bit with your fingers. Don't have to press hard. So there you are. You've got your front part all slicked and with your gasket in the back. Now, the next bit is to think about the retaining screws. Okay, for the next step, just get some very thin super glue. Super glue comes in various types, you know, viscous, normal. This is just household grade. It's pretty thin anyway. It's important that you have thin super glue because it will wick into the gaps. So you will have got these couple of screws and these retaining discs here. And here are your spacers. So get one of the retaining discs. It's got two surfaces, kind of like a sharp edge and a slightly softer one where it's been punched. So put your screw through there like that. And then look at the little spacer, and you'll see that it's normally got one flat surface and one that's got slightly indented. Put the flat surface so it goes towards the retaining disc. And then just wind that up till it goes to the end. And just make sure that the disc is able to turn. Get yourself a little thin piece of wire or a nail or whatever, and dip the end in the super glue, and then just twirl the screw slowly in your fingers as you drip the super glue on this edge there. And it will drag itself into the screw threads by capillary action. Just let that lie there for a second. Do the other one. Again, look at the little washer. See where the flat bit is. There's the flat bit. And put that towards the retaining disc. Don't tighten it up too much. Dip your nail or wire in the super glue and very slowly rotate the screw as you go. Just leave those to dry for a bit. Okay, that's pretty much good to go now. So basically what you've got is a freely revolving retaining disc, but the actual spacer is will stay in place. Take one of those in your fingers and just start it into the at one end on the hole, and just have a look down to see that it's nicely lined up, sort of it's going in there in a perpendicular this way and that, just before you start screwing it in. And then get your screwdriver, give it about 15 turns. And that's looking pretty good. Okay, so that one's in there. Now we'll do the other one. Start it again with your fingers. Look down the line of the screws to make sure that both of them are in line. That's looking good. And just give it about 15 turns. So there we are. That's all there is to it, to make your front unit for the Octa-Harp. Now this can also work as a tremolo harp, or you can have two harps, a fifth apart or whatever. So let's see how that sounds. So this is one I made earlier. I'm just going to pull the harps out. To remove the harps just takes about five turns, and then they'll just flop out. Now you can see these ones are fully valved. There's other videos on valving and also on my custom power combs. Now the good thing about my combs is they've got valve pockets. You can see that they've got these quite big indents at the back of each chamber there, and that's to allow the inside valves to go fit inside the comb without snarling on the comb and getting jammed. So if you do want to valve your octave harmonica, which I would thoroughly recommend, it will make life a little bit easier if you use one of our power combs. You don't have to do that, you can use a stock comb, but you'll probably have to gouge out some pockets at the back to take the valves, because many stock combs just don't have room for them. For the moment, I'll just put these two harps together in the new Octa-Harp, just to show you how it sounds. So because you've only put the screws in about 15 turns, that one will just pop in there. The other one will pop in that way, and then just tighten up your screws . Just keep going until the washer starts to get a little bit hard to turn. Okay, so I can still turn it, but it's taking me a little bit of pressure, and that's about all you need. So there it is, your completed Octa-Harp. You can see how easy it is to make, and let's see how it sounds. Such a beautiful sound, the octave sound. I really, recommend you trying out one of these. But I have to stress that it will sound a lot better with being fully valved. I mean, you can just throw in a crossover, Hohner crossover, and a Hohner Thunderbird into one of these without valves, and it will work, but because it's got double the number of reeds, it's double the amount of air loss going on. If you put the valves in, that halves that air loss, and you get a really strong, loud sound. Embossing and all that will help as well, but basically you just have to take those harmonicas, valve them, and put them in here, and then you just get an amazing, awesome octave sound. Okay, bye for now.